what Triangle Microwix does is it's able to simulate all the devices you'd find in a typical substation, and then also monitors how those devices can communicate with each other, and you can set up in different configurations to kind of test your substation design and everything else. It also comes with an analysis tool so you can deep dive into those communication protocols and gain almost an intuitive understanding of how everything's talking to each other. Okay, this thing's not working. I can track through the chain and figure out this is the exact issue going on here. And the students, you know, I'm in a classroom, I'm learning theory all day, but you don't get that kind of critical thinking, that debugging knowledge you get when you sit down with the problem and go through it. So this is the substation layout that we have in the demo. And it goes out to different places. We have two transformers down here, so it steps down the voltage, it goes out to our distribution lines. And all these devices are simulated, so these are breakers, just the switches, the transformers. So we can simulate different kind of fault scenarios if different things go wrong and everything like that. So if I were to click this fault button, we'll see this breaker open, close. I hope at least. There you go. So you see the breaker open and close, the current transformer value changes, and it captures all that in simulation. So this is just kind of the building tool, and it's kind of all working on the new modern standard, IEC. So in the old days, you had a bunch of DNP communication protocols. All of the substations were kind of out of sync. And we're moving away from that toward a new modern standard, where you can generate a file, do analysis on the file, build that file out, and then upload that file to the substation. It's kind of where the standard's heading at. So going into the communication protocols, this is a really cool tool. So each one of these is a device in the substation itself. And inside the device, you can see like different logical functions. You can kind of see, this is kind of a thought that occurs with like you have a instantaneous overvoltage, overcurrent, and it will trigger throughout the rest of this line trying to reopen it. So if something goes wrong, it immediately sends that signal out to close the breaker, and you can kind of see how it all just traverses through the network. All the messages that go through here get captured, so you can read it up and open it like packet and read the packets out. So over here is the goose tracker. You can open it up, and these are kind of like different newspapers inside the substation each machine subscribes to. So not every machine needs to know what every other machine's doing, but you can subscribe to a certain newspaper and get very quick information about what other machines are doing. So if a fault occurs, you can quickly get that information, do what you gotta do with it, and then you'll get messages back. So students can go in here, they can see the sample values from the line, they can see all the messages going back and forth, and you can really get a hands-on, very deep understanding of how a substation works.
Are these devices part of the equipment you have here, or are they all from simulations?
This is just a simulation, so it's a different setup of how we have it here.
But you could tie those real devices into that same network and monitor it with this tool, mm-hmm. with the simulation in the other tool that he was showing, so that you could like bench test some of this equipment with a large amount of equipment that's simulated in the field. So if you want to do like load testing or something like that,
yeah.